Hello and welcome to 5-Minute Math. Today we are looking at the 7th grade concept of calculating tax. This is standard 7.13a in the great state of Texas, and we are using item number 30 of the 2017 released STAR test. If you have not done so already, please go ahead and take a moment to pause the video, work this problem out on your own, unpause it, and we will look at our answers together. So we have a doctor with an annual, this annual means yearly, in case we're wondering, yearly income of $152,125. Pretty good. We have an income tax. So an income tax is something that we have to pay on our income to the government. It's part of the way that they get their money to pay for schools and roads and the military and healthcare and all of that business. So the income tax taxes people that make money, and he's paying a 6% flat income tax. So we just need to figure out what is the amount of the income tax in dollars and cents that the doctor has to pay. All right, so probably the easiest way to look at it would be to kind of write it out like this. We need to find 6% of our 152,125. So it's going to be a much smaller amount. We could, if we wanted to, make a proportion here, and we could say, right, we could do this 6%, turn that into a fraction, would be 6/100, and then your 100% of the is this full thing right here, so 152,125, and then let's say x is the 6% that we're looking for, and then you could just do a little bit of cross multiplication, right? You can do 6 times this, and then you'd have to end up dividing it by 100 to isolate that x. Or another way to just kind of save yourself the step of writing it out would be to go ahead and multiply straight by this decimal. So 6% is a percent, but if we want to turn percent into a decimal, we've put the decimal. If it's not already there, put it after the ones place. We're going to move it over once. We're going to move over twice. Move over 2 times, because remember, we've got 6/100 is what equals 6%. So that equals 0.06. So what we do is we end up multiplying this by 0.06, and that is the exact same as multiplying it by 6 and then dividing it by 100, because 6 divided by 100 is this right here, this 0.06. So it just kind of saves you a step. Turn the percent into a decimal and then just multiply it. So 6 times 5 is 30. 6 times 2 is 12. Carry the 3. 15. 6 times 1 is 6. Add the 1 is 7. 6 times 2 is 12 again. 6 times 5 is 30 again, but we need to add that 1 to get to 31. And then you've got 6 times 1 is 6. Add that 3 is 9. Now, this might be looking to you like this is way too large, 912,750. But remember, we have 2 digits behind the decimal in our factor, so we need 2 digits behind the decimal in our product. So this x right here, if we wanted to go and write that out, is going to equal this $9,127.50. That is 6% of the full income of $152,125. Well, we could do all of that correct, and we could still get the answer wrong if we don't bubble it in correctly. So your answer is going to look something like this. On your answer document, you're going to have a little rectangle up on top. You're going to have a very long column with no bubbles, and it's going to be kind of off-centered here. And that's our decimal. So you've got 2 digits to the right of the decimal, and you're going to end up having 4 digits to the left of the decimal. This is all we get on our 7th grade answer document. And so we're going to need every single one of these. So we need $9,127.50. Now, we don't really need that zero. We can bubble it in without the zero if we want to, but just make sure we bubble everything in, and we're good.